Hello and welcome to Man's Last Stand. I'm your host Solo. Today's show, we discuss about the morning after, you know?
And not the bill.
And not the bill. The morning after, you know, when often we get, sometimes we get into compromising situations where we end up with people who are not our spouses.
You know? We, you and who?
You,
Roy Karise and Nico Biambo.
Roy the Great does not go through such situations. Nico the Phenomenal stomach might have gone
through it. It's a bitch boy. And Shafi.
Hey, boss, hey, talk about yourself.
Still in denial, eh?
Scrappy Shabby.
So you're talking about
one night stands, okay? Yeah. And the morning after, how it should be treated. And probably we should start by saying, how did we get even into it?
Saying or talking?
As a celebrity, how? I can't say that you get in this situation when you have groupies. Mm-hmm. Just say, Nick, just for one night, ravish this my body. And I say, yes. Come to my palatial house.
That is for personalities, celebrities, blah, blah, blah.
This guy's called his palatial. You know, this is the only home where you can touch everything with one move. The toilet, the kitchen,
like a call box.
The TV.
So Nick says, what you're saying is groupie love.
Yeah.
Oh,
so basically,
oh my God.
This is people one. You take, end
this
up taking.
This is all yours. Like, yes,
man. I agree, because he's talking about women who you end up taking because you're under pressure, because they're on your case.
Like
boches,
like the house girls in the estate.
Shafi, you stop messing up around with the boches. All these years,
so you remember about
Anna Penanjaro Zaman
Bouch. And I say, wale wademo na kuseduce. Have you ever been seduced?
This guy should be the estate celebrity. All the boches like him. Shafi.
So what happens is, a woman actually comes up to you, gets overexcited about you, and you're overwhelmed.
And you end up with her.
You end up with her. And he didn't choose to be with her, she chose to be with you.
So it's
you let her take control of your night. Now you shut my vibe, it's so good. And what is underneath is even better. So in the end, you end up going with her.
Yes.
So you got overwhelmed.
Yes.
For me, I think it's a totally different situation.
What's your take?
You end up leaving with these women half of the time because of an idle mind or idle time.
What do you mean?
You know how they say an idle mind is the devil's
workshop.
Yeah. When you have too much time on your hand or too much things to spare, then you start looking at opportunities to take advantage of. For example, if you have a girlfriend or wife who's traveled and what, you start thinking about, so what am I going to do with the time?
And
I
you know, I'm just going to stay alone. Yeah.
And then all the blood from the brain just goes down to the other head.
You look at the opportunities, I haven't worked, or I'm not working tomorrow, of the day off.
Yes, yes.
So all that time starts now beginning to overwhelm you, and you start realizing, why not I have the time?
Yes.
Or why not it's not going to cost me anything? Or
and
why
also, why waste the space in the bed?
Exactly.
You're used to sleeping with someone. When they're not there, you're allowed to, you know.
Representative.
They call what? Free agents.
Yes.
Supporting cast.
I think that's a lot of guys in this town, it's because of that thing. The girl
it's because
has
of
disappeared.
Idleness.
Whatever. It's idleness. Mm-hmm. You need to realize that you need to fill your time with other things, but that we'll discuss later. Mm-hmm. But it's like actually idle time that causes you to start thinking about why not?
The extracurricular.
Since I have a space in the bed.
Why are you ignoring me?
Ignoring.
Why are you ignoring me?
Ignoring you.
So what are the extracurricular activities you can occupy yourself so that you do not bring someone into that bed?
You play a game of Scrabble.
You play with your organ. You play with your organ. Anyway, me, all I can say, how people get themselves into this situation of one night stands, and then you have this big dilemma of morning after, is pombe.
Pombe.
Keroro.
Keroro.
Yes.
Are you
you know, they say, love is in the eye of the beer holder.
The beer holder.
There's always that chick who is single at the bar.
Yeah, at the bar.
And that is the one you end up with.
You know what you have to
do? You sound like a prowler. Is that why you like buying so much alcohol?
What happened?
That is another influence.
Yeah,
so there's always a man who's always hunting.
Keroro, not hunting. It just happens.
It's on the prowl.
No, it's when you have a good budget. If you're picking free, you won't be above free because you know tomorrow you'll go on a budget.
Yeah.
And you won't have the budget. So you always do that when you know you have a lot of money. But where I agree with Shafi is that in every bar at 9 p.m., everyone is ugly. At 2 a.m., the bar is full
of
people.
And the easiest family, the drunk chick.
What you need to start doing.
Not the drunk chick.
Is decide.
Are you praying on a drunk one?
Yeah? right?
You are rapist, bro.
Right on a piece. Right.
I'm advising.
Let us get to here.
I'm advising the people who have got the problem.
Who?
Take a huge piece of paper and write. Everyone in this club is ugly. You fold that piece of paper.
Which clubs
are they? Just go right.
Every time.
Everybody is ugly in this club.
Like Memento.
So even at home, you'll chomoka peke yako.
You only then you walk with it like so now when you're going out. We're all ugly in this club. Yeah. Anyway, but basically, guys, it's time. Mm-hmm. It's alcohol because that day you have fun. Mm-hmm. And as Nick says, you're overwhelmed. Yeah. You're overwhelmed. And that's what actually
calls it. And I like the
big I know overwhelmed. People like you don't go through that situation where you're overwhelmed a lot. But it's a very...
And you can't afford alcohol. Yeah. So you never get them when it's drunk.
So now these are the ones who get CSR Kirika.
And Penzi Sabuni.
Oh. Pamela Joe.
These are guys of donations.
Donations, yes.
Boda Boda. You know that the women who are called, you know Boda Boda?
Yes.
The girls who share their talent with everyone. Mm-hmm. Everyone gets a ride.
They call the village bicycles.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes they become village motorbikes. When they can move.
But in that situation, there is also this idea of there could be a chick that you've been eyeing for a long time. Right? There's always that mama. Yeah. She's not your chick. She's always mad at you, but you've always thought, what would happen if I ever this thing?
Then
not
eventually she comes through.
Okay?
That's
right?
Nice that's not how you treat her. Let me be very honest. Mm-hmm. Those situations are so rare. The fact that you've been eyeing her for a long time, the only thing you have on her is just an eye. Just keep it like that, my brother.
Now you're in the friend zone after a certain period.
After a certain period, that
you'll never get it.
She even
unless she gets super drunk. Like,
there are only three ways of getting them, mm-hmm. or getting yourself in that situation. Mm-hmm. You have money to buy yourself alcohol, and then obviously you stop thinking.
Thinking?
And you think you can have anything.
Yes.
Or you have a gap. Beautiful. What I'm saying, time.
Or
you have a gap.
Gap, which is time.
Yes.
You're just becoming irresponsible. Tamayi of hisi.
Yes.
Or you just sneak.
Groupie.
He believes everyone loves him.
Some housemates who have just been chasing
women actually
for
do love me. Mm-hmm. So ladies, you can post on the Man's Last Stand Facebook page. I will give you a certain date and look for you.
Wait.
Some heavy deep.
Wait.
Ladies, better watch out. Nick is on a scroll.
He has a Facebook page.
No, he said on Man's Last Stand. So it's all right.
He's a Facebook page.
We'll definitely get it. But then, the morning after, how should we deal with it? You know, sometimes...
How should we deal with it?
Yes.
What do you mean? Should we deal with it?
You see,
after dealing with it, how do you deal with yourself?
Like for example, you're talking about alcohol, yeah? Mm-hmm. Right? And Roy said very well that at 9 p.m., everybody's ugly. 2 a.m., everybody looks pretty, everybody's funny.
Even you.
Even me, yeah?
They're
right?
Not funny.
But then you end up with a chick.
Funny, there's a bull never be funny.
Be funny. They
can be funny looking, not funny.
Funny.
They can be funny weird, not funny.
there are those chicks who are called chungulia.
Can be funny.
You know, what?
You know those chicks called chungulia?
You don't come from the slum. You have to tell me this guy. They're called what? Chungulia.
Chungulia.
Is it like a cup where you pour a chungulia?
I'll explain to you. Chungulia is that chick that you pick up from a club, right? Then in the morning you realize she's not all that, and you want neighbors to see that she's coming from your crib. You know, sometimes you say, toka, or you always lie like.
You tell me, wait, how do they enter your house? Through the door or through the window?
By any means, she just has to get out and
nobody has to know
that she was in your crib.
even a cab girl tell you, come on and get away with me. So you don't come and eat a ribbon. Let me ask you.
Yes.
There's a chick who's so bad.
Yeah.
Even the mochas are laughing at you. So no. Are they called what?
Chungulia.
Where?
Right? Chungulia. You have Chungulia.
Her face.
You said you live in Mukuru, eh?
No.
Which is called what?
I live in the palace.
Her face is allergic to mirrors.
Palatial slab.
When your mirror looks at her, it turns away.
Yes, a 7 bedrooms, atop a house. No, Mukuru.
Yes.
Wait.
Educators.
And she looks how?
Chungulia is that chick, and I'm sure almost every man has chipped a chick who's
No. Let me explain.
Even you are like,
every man.
Look what the cat dragged home.
I just hope this. Mm-hmm. Every man has the lowest common denominator.
There's a place
where you, even if you come what? You know, each guy's one, they say, I never call a chick of this size,
yes.
Of this color,
yes.
Or who speaks like this.
Yes.
Like me, I don't like too much slang.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm.
Chungulias.
So you have yours.
Slang
or maybe, yeah, I know, I never go with a woman who has golden hair.
Yeah.
You all have your funny thing of flash, of shiny clothes.
Yes.
But you have an LCD. You are saying there's somewhere you have reached a level where...
Even him is embarrassed.
You pass your LCD.
Are you trying to say
what
that
is this
you got an old dad back here?
No,
back.
Listen. Are you trying to say...
Wait.
No. Back here, back. Roy, are you trying to say you've never gone below your LCD?
What?
Yeah?
No, none of us have.
Just you.
Let me sell yourself.
Everybody is in denial here. Shafi.
What?
There is no way.
You've collected...
You're the only one who knew the definition of Chungulia.
Even like when you're out of town and... Everybody has gone, you are alone.
I think
he's
the guy who remember.
Watch and it's
going. He's the guy who remember them are bartenders.
Let me ask you. You know, I think even mosquitoes come, they say, ah, ta easy.
Mosquitoes become vegetarians.
No.
You've really let us down.
You let us down. You're embarrassing us.
Morning after to night, morning, night never, before. What did you carry? Wait.
All right, guys. I think
the neighbors keep telling their toys. Usipokula ule msichana atakuja hapa. Mami nitakula. Nitakula.
All right, guys. No.
Listen.
Wait. If I see another chick like that.
Wait. On the gate. This property is protected by his rule.
Listen, no. This is the man's last stand. So Lord, be given a time out. Talk to the hand. Lot of the devils. Shut up.
You don't have a lowest common denominator. No. You can remember anything.
You've been suspended for 5 minutes.
My rant. Eugene Wamalwa, a.k.a. the endorser.
Yeah.
See, that guy's endorsed everyone. I endorse Harry Kibaki. I endorse Musalia Mudavadi. I endorse myself.
I endorse Solo.
I endorse Solo. Okay.
One more game, girl. Today I'm endorsing Jesus.
Listen,
this is for Jesus. Jesus Alliance.
Well, we're doing a minimization. We have to take over the show. Anyway, this is man's last time. We'll be right back.